I bought this 4-jaw rotary axis a while ago, and I'm planning to use it both as a rotary axis and as a lathe. To do that, I built a control box, which is based on an Arduino Uno module with a simple display. And it contains actually only three buttons plus the rotary encoder for setting the RPM, and also a BCD encoder, which will allow me to set the acceleration in 7 steps. Apart from that, there is also a switch, which if I flip to the left, it means the rotational axis will act as a lathe, or if I switch it to the right, then the CNC will control the rotation of the rotary axis. The push buttons are quite self-explanatory in function. There is one for counterclockwise rotation and one for clockwise rotation, and one, of course, to stop the rotation altogether. The LCD displays the necessary information with the set RPM and the actual running RPM, as well as the direction of rotation, clockwise or counterclockwise, or if the stop button is pushed, then stop is displayed. So it's really a very simple design. It contains all the basic functions I can come up with right now. I don't have any experience in using a lathe, so I will toy with this one. The rotary encoder's push button function is connected to the Arduino reset, so it will act as an emergency stop. To run the rotary axis, I designed and built a power supply delivery. The PSU box not only contains the power supplies, but also a stepper driver called DM542, as well as the necessary connections, one to the CNC, one to the lathe control box, and one to the motor, of course. These are the dip switch settings I'm using on the DM542. Basically, it's full current and 400 steps per revolution. So let's start some testing, slow rotation, 50 RPM first, and I will demonstrate all the functions. This was the slowest acceleration also. Of course, at this slow RPM, you can have maximum acceleration also. Changing rotation direction means that the control box slowly decelerates, reducing speed to zero, and then changes direction and accelerates up again. Of course, if direction changing is necessary, you don't have to push the stop button first and then the other direction button, but you can swap anytime. Change directions to left or right. At this speed, even my table starts to vibrate a bit, so that's the extra noise you are hearing. So now let's test the maximum revolution, which I set to 380 RPM for the chuck. That's because that is really 2280 RPM for the stepper, which is very high. In my previous tests, I could run it much faster than that, up to 410 RPM also, but I found that the stepper stalls far too easy, so I think that would be pretty useless. For now I have 380 RPM as maximum, but you have to remember that that is actually quite high. It means 15,200 steps per minute, or 253 steps per second. So it is very fast for a stepper. 2280 RPM is fast. This is what happens if the emergency stop button is pressed, which is the rotation encoder push button function. The rotation stops extremely fast, even at the highest speed. The current use is moderate, about 1.5 amps maximum, without any load, except the chuck itself. So I think I have a good enough margin before the PSU is overloaded, and also before the maximum current of 3 amps or for the stepper is reached. Switching direction of rotation or stopping the chuck rotation is possible at any time during the acceleration or deceleration phase of the stepper. So there is no need to push the stop button and wait for deceleration to zero before pushing the direction button for the other direction. Switching to CNC mode. There is really not much to say about this, except that now the CNC is controlling the rotation axis stepper. This is the same mode as if I switch the control box completely off or disconnect it from the rotation axis power supply. The control box has no function at all in this mode. That's it for now. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it, and welcome back next time.